Welcome back, nerds. Fino here with a guide for the new Caldea Boys event. An old spider spins webs of memory. Participation just requires Fuyuki, so it's as good a time as any to jump in. Your reward for completing the event story is a holy grail, so you'll want to get it done. Right off the bat, you get a special item that you can trade for one of this year's Caldea Boys craft essences. As usual, the 3 stars aren't worth considering, and the 4 stars generally aren't either. The only 4 star I'd consider is Cunning Foresight. It has Sure Hit, which, depending on your account's power level, might be a nice bit of utility. With that said, with one strike does something similar, and it's in the standard pool, so it's not like you're getting something super rare out of it. 5 star wise, you have the Dante's Files, the Case of the True Mastermind. It gives quick, crit damage and NP generation. Probably my favorite art out of this year's set, but stat-wise, it's health-heavy. Quick attackers generally want starting charge, so that's another nail in the coffin. Then there's Dance with a Round Table, which is probably the one I'd go with. Star Absorption and NP gain. Nothing amazing, but with a full attack investment, you can stick it on whatever and get something done. As you can see, the power level of CEs this year is relatively low. Log in every day for Mysterious Glasses. You can trade these for summon tickets and Moriarty's Command Code. It removes debuff immunity and increases crit damage against good alignment enemies. Situational, but useful. Moriarty gets a bartender costume. You can buy it for cocktail shakers in the event shop. Even if you don't have him, you can buy it and sit on it for later. He also gets a strengthening. His charge skill still needs 10 stars, but now it doesn't use them. It also gives your frontline the evil alignment, which pairs well with his attack buff. For event notes, all male and genderless servants gain 50% extra damage. The Caldea Boy CEs give drop bonuses corresponding to their rarity. 3 stars give coasters, 4 stars give cloth, and 5 stars give cocktail shakers. For currency farming, the first 3 free quests are crap. Instead, go with Milk for coasters, Soda for cloth, Rock for shakers, and Straight if you don't have CEs, since it gives all 3. The nodes aren't anything special difficulty-wise. Normal players can deal with them as usual, and Scotty teams will find them trivial. There's also a challenge quest that pits you against Sherlock Holmes. As per usual, it requires Solomon completion to access. I'll do a separate video on it once I find my clear footage, but it's pretty easy all things considered. The Ultra TLDR version is that you can borrow a Jalter, wait 5 turns for his starting buffs to expire, and burn him down before he stacks a large number of buffs. And that's all I've got. Thanks for watching. Like if you liked the video, subscribe for more, and come watch me on Twitch where I stream every weekend, 3 PM Pacific time, Friday through Sunday. This week I'm making a terrible mistake, and thanks to a bit goal, that infamous Geronimo account is making a comeback for one day and one day only. You'll want to follow me on Twitch for this one because it's a guaranteed shit show. See you there.